Thank you. I'm lucky because I had my first computer in 1977. And I could be an actor. I've been also a programmer. I've been observing the evolution of technology, but I'm not going to talk about technology, all the buzzwords, IA, cloud, but I will talk about what are the influence of technology on the way we live, we communicate, and we operate on a daily basis. The first thing, and I've said this on this stage, which is more important than ever, the big revolution that technology has brought to us is the access, the instant access to knowledge. Knowledge has been an asset discriminating the poor and the rich during centuries. And at the end of the beginning of 2000, through blogs, through Wikipedia, it became an asset shared. And all the students, on an estate basis, everything was shared through blog and through some website. So what does it mean for the people? When you keep information for you during ages and you share it, it creates new reflex. You share your car, you share your home, you share your apartment, you share your office, you share information. And what does it mean for the business is if you share your car, you know you have business like BlaBlaCar popping up. If you share your experience, you take pictures, you share with your friends on the various social network what you do. Then you can rent also your apartment through Airbnb. I have a team right now looking for an office in Paris. There are 10, and the three offers they got was not traditional office, but co-location. So what does it mean for business people? It totally changed the way they have to operate. Carlos Ghosn really explained very well yesterday. During many years, car makers were producing car. Now they are going to produce a service to go from A to B. Another thing which is which has a big impact on our life. This morning, you should have all received the statistic on how you've been using your iPhones. Because we're reasonable people, we have had maybe 100 interactions during the week. But some kids in the US, they have 500 connections per day. So what does it mean for the brain? Instead of delivering a short process during 4 hours, that's what we used to do, reading a book or whatever, every 7-10 seconds, the brain is attacked. What does it mean then? It means the neuronal topology of the brain is being reconfigured. It creates addictions, it creates also a new form of depression, and it creates also some avatars. I organized a board 3 weeks ago with 14 people, and I told them, no iPhone during 4 hours, and no tablets. And it was funny to see the reaction of the people, because after 10, 20 minutes, some of them were really in an addiction mode, like cigarettes or alcohol or whatever. So little by little, this interaction with the brain become an addiction. Another impact also is we all communicate on a daily basis, on an asynchronous basis. We have friends who are overseas or families or whatever, and we share experience. So the more we communicate like that, the more we need to be together. So a new set of business are exploding, music concert, sports bar. And now in Paris, as an example, you can see in London, after work, hundreds of young people hanging around the bar. One thing also which I've changed, technology has changed in our habit, is the way we shop. We have all e-shop. But what are the impact on the network of shops? All the corner store now are doing very well because it's convenient. All the big shops, the big mall like Apple Store, is an experience, so you go there, hang around. But the in-between shops is not convenient, it's not fun, and it's not an experience. So except the Apple Store where you go there to hang around, as an example in London, 35% of the commercial surfaces between 400 meters, square meters and 8,000 meters have no future. Another example is entertainment. We, in our younger age, we were buying LPs, CDs, cassette, DVDs, and whatever. And now, nobody buys cassette. You go on the net, you have Netflix. And not only that, but now, all the young generation do not look at TV on the linear TV, but are looking at Netflix and things like that. So my point here, and I'm not going to describe everything, that little by little, not only the technology changed the way we operate, but change also our relationship with things, the way we operate. That means, because the change is very fast, the impact on the traditional business of CapEx and OpEx, you know, create a huge paradigm, which is very difficult to anticipate. And Carlos Ghosn yesterday really emphasized the facts. So just to finish, what is next? In the next 18 months, there will be three main revolutions that will even change more our life. First of all, the speed of communication will be multiplied by 10. So the 5G or the 5G plus will move our communication from 100 meg to 1 gigabit or 10 gigabit. Second, the next generation of sensor, IoT, quantum computing will make the things much faster, much smaller, and in a few years from now, you will have a chip in your body like a plane will reset all the data and say, you can work, you can sleep, you can drive, and whatever. And last, the next generation of algorithm will take in the cloud all the programs aggregated on a real-time basis at the speed of light, and then we'll provide on a real-time basis all the algorithms to make the things faster and cheaper and whatever. And here, and we're not going to talk about artificial intelligence, all this change, the data will be faster than our human reflex, then we can talk about IA. Just a data, the speed of internet is about 300,000 kilometers per second is the light, you know, it's speed of light. In the brain, the speed of data, you know, is 100 meters per second. So there is a competition right now between the brain and between the process of watching things and operating things as a reflex. Mm-hmm. So is the future bright or not? I don't know. But we need to be very careful about how do we use technology, because it impacts our life, the way we communicate, and we need to be very careful with our kids to make sure they still have a normal life and play with toys like we've done when we were younger.
Toys. Yes. Thank you, François.